Do you have anger about this? Do you have, I mean, you've been 22 and a half years in here for something you say you didn't do.
Something I didn't do.
Are you angry about that?
Initially, I was coming into prison, but then you have to let go of that anger. You can't live like that. I see it this way, that things that you have no control of, don't try to control the things you have no control of.
You said you miss the simple things in life. What are those simple things that you miss?
I mean, just being out and about, taking long walks, being able to see the moon, being able to try and count the stars.
How long has it been since you've seen the moon, since you've seen the sky?
Well, sometimes we got these little windows with these little slits where we can look out. And sometimes I'm looking out, you can't see them because of the angle that the building is. And you know they're there. I know they're there, though, but you just can't see them.
And now you're scheduled for execution in a matter of weeks. Take me inside your head now. What's going through your mind?
The love for my supporters, my friends, my mother. As long as my mother, she's standing up and staying strong, you know, I have to stay strong.
Are there times when you actually contemplate that this is scheduled and the number of days you have left in this world, the number of weeks that you have, you can count on your fingers?
Well, I really don't entertain those thoughts. I mean, when you ask me about it like right now, and I do realize how close it is and how short time is, how short life is, really. It's a serious matter, but I try not to entertain that.
Well, Rodney's mother, Sandra, his brother, Roderick, and Stacy's cousin, Heather, and Rodney's attorney, Bryce, have been fighting for Rodney for a long time. This has been very difficult for you, obviously. It's been 22 and a half years.
Yes.
It's scheduled now for November 20th.
Yes.
What do you say to yourself about this?
I'm like Rodney. I'm not entertaining it right now. I just can't do it. I'm holding on to faith, the truth, and that's what we're here for, the truth, to get it out here.
Do you believe he's going to be set free?
Yes, I do. I have to hold on to that. Mm-hmm. Yes, I do. He must. All the evidence. He must be free.
What do you think about this, Roderick?
I think that right out of the gate, my brother didn't have a shot. I think this case is a prime example why they should abolish the death penalty.
That's right.
Because it is so corrupt. It is racist, it is biased, and all those things have played a major role in my brother's case.
Yes.
And we stand here today saying that we are tired, and the state of Texas ought to be tired, because one life is too many.
Well, Heather, you think he's innocent, but the rest of the family sees it differently, right?
Her mother and her sister see it differently. Mm-hmm. There are a lot of cousins that agree that at the very minimum, he should have a new trial.
Right. And do you believe that he murdered Stacy?
No, I don't believe that he murdered Stacy.
Why not?
When this first happened, even her sisters were suspicious of Jimmy Finnell. There's a note that her sister wrote that details points that they were concerned about. And I don't understand how they went from that to where their belief is now, her mom and her sisters.
This gets stranger
yes.
by the minute when you dig into it.